not to. And I asked, you know, Sheikh Abdullah about Abd al-Muttalib, because when you read Abd al-Muttalib's, Abu Talib, who's the uncle of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the brother of Abd al-Muttalib, when you read about Abu Talib, it's amazing what he did for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and his love for the Prophet, he stood by the Prophet, and some of the ulama say that he was Muslim. Malal Ainain, one of the great Mauritanian scholars, wrote a book arguing that he was. There is a tradition that says Al-Abbas heard him say the Shahada on the deathbed, but the Prophet didn't hear it. So the Prophet said, I didn't hear him. So he couldn't testify for two witnesses that he was Muslim. The hadith in Sahih Muslim, it's in the Sahih that he akhafu nas adaba, that he's the least of people punished. That's ahad hadith. And aqidah, our belief is al-aqidah la tathbutu bil-ahad. Aqidah is not something that you can establish with solitary narrations, which is very important to understand this. Ibn Taymiyyah and the, in the Salafi tradition, they do establish aqidah with ahad. And that's why they have a lot of points of dissension with the Ash'ari and the Maturidi. These are khilaf issues. Now, part of the problem is that when you have people that don't accept khilaf, then there's no dialogue, there's no debate about it. But our tradition demands that we accept khilaf. If there's a khilaf about an issue, then you can't say this or that. It's not mujma' alayh. So I asked Sheikh Abdullah, he just said tawakkuf. Yani for him, I don't want to say either or. But his position is ahad do not establish aqidah. And to say somebody's in hell is, with any certainty is very dangerous. So to say Abu Talib is in hell is just something Muslims should not, even if the hadith is sahih, it's an ahad hadith and it's a matter of aqidah. And so, be very careful about these things, because إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتُ. Allah says that the Prophet loved Abu Talib. The Prophet ﷺ loved Abu Talib. That ayah came down about Abu Talib, that you do not guide who you love. وَلَكِنَ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah guides whomever He pleases. So, the best position is Allahu A'lam. And people that say the Prophet's parents are in the fire, Qadi Abu Bakr said people should be whipped that do that. That was his opinion. And you can have, there's a hadith which is sahih. Aina abi? Abi wa abuka fi an-nar. Your father and my father are in the fire. That's a sound hadith. Again, it's an ahad hadith, first and foremost. And second, what did the Prophet mean by his father? He could have meant his uncle, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab. Because the Arabs say father for uncle. Abu Talib, when Bahira asked who's his father? He said, Ana. He said, Man Abuhu? He said, Ana. I'm his father. And he said, it doesn't seem that his father should be alive. He said, I'm his uncle. But he wasn't lying when he said that he was his father, because the Arabs called the uncle the father. So those type things are, they're just better left alone. But our belief is that the Prophet's parents are saved. That's the dominant opinion, that they're saved. They're people of fetra, the between messengers, and they didn't. And then there's a weak hadith that Shamsuddin Dimashqi mentions, that Allah actually, when the Prophet visited, he was allowed to visit his mother, and that Allah actually raised them from the dead, and they believed him. It's a weak hadith, but he says, that he doesn't have a problem believing it. Alhamdulillah, so. Again, it's aqidah, and so you can't establish anything with it. That's the dominant opinion.